we can bring sacrifices back into the picture here on planet Earth without them disrupting or competing with Yeshua's once and for all heavenly sacrifice. You understand what I'm saying there? We don't have to imagine that the earthly animal sacrifices, when they're brought back into use, will somehow compete with Yeshua's sacrifice. Not at all. They don't have to. It's because in verse 18, as I'm drawing to a close, the writer book of Hebrews says, where there is forgiveness of these, there's no longer any offering for sin. He doesn't mean by saying that there's no longer any offering for sin that this means that there will no longer be any need for the earthly system. Not at all. What I believe he's trying to say, if I can fill in some of the words that he didn't use, but by context he must have implied them, is that where there's forgiveness of these at the heavenly level, on the internal level, where there's forgiveness of these heart sins, where there's forgiveness of the transgression at the infinite level, right, which is in the heavenly level, where there's a forgiveness of the stain that, of sin that Adam brought into a picture, thousands of years ago, where there's a forgiveness of this, there's no longer any offering for sin at that heavenly level as well. In other words, Yeshua doesn't have to die again. He will never have to die again, people. Baruch Hashem, right? It's because of the effectiveness of his sacrifice. And that's why the writer is trying to get his readers to understand that the eternal forgiveness that Yeshua's offering provided for us is so effectual that we no longer ever need to expect or pray that Yeshua need to return to heaven again. It's just like the earthly picture that was painted by the Yom Kippur.